हो। टुडेज लेक्चर इज ऑन हाइब्रिड पैरामीटर्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ अदर पैरामीटर्स। लेट अस लुक एट द फर्स्ट कन्वर्जन, हाइब्रिड पैरामीटर इन टर्म्स ऑफ जेड पैरामीटर्स। एज डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स, व्हेनेवर वी स्टार्ट विद कन्वर्जन, व्हाट आर वी एक्सपेक्टेड टू डू इज वी आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू राइट द इक्वेशंस ऑफ दोज पैरामीटर्स। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद हाइब्रिड पैरामीटर्स। सो हाइब्रिड पैरामीटर्स रिलेट्स V1 I2 with I1 V2, whereas Z parameter relates V1 V2 with I1 I2 of the two port network. To convert hybrid into Z, we need to look into the Z parameter equation and identify which equation could have a closer match with the hybrid parameter. Right? So if we look closer into the equations of Z parameter, which we have called as equation number 3 and 4, we observe that in equation number 4, we have parameters like V2, I1, I2. In equation 4, we identify parameters like two port network elements V2, I1, I2. Now, if we compare this with the equation number 2, equation number 2 also has similar parameters I2, I1, V2. So similar current and voltage parameters are identified in equation 2 and equation number 4, and therefore what we can do is equation number 4 can be rearranged. So equation number 4 is rearranged as shown here, I2 in terms of I1 and V2. So that we get a very closer match with equation number 2. We want I2 in terms of I1 V2. So therefore we will rearrange equation number 4 and get I2 in terms of I1 V2. So with this rearrangement, we have obtained I2 in terms of I1 and V2. Right? So you could see here, we have placed this Z22, I2 on the left hand side, rest of the elements on the right hand side. Moving the Z22 on the right hand side, we get this equation. And then we rearrange it so that we write I1 earlier followed by V2, because we are going to compare this with equation number 2, in which we have I1 followed by V2. And therefore, to match it exactly with equation number 2, we have also rearranged this equation so that we have I1 followed by V2. So with this rearrangement, now we can say that we have exactly matching with equation number 2, and we can identify that the term associated with I1 can be called as H21. So as you see in equation number 2, the term associated with I1 is H21, and the term associated with V2 is H22. So therefore we get H21 and H22 by rearranging equation 4. So H21 is minus Z21 by Z22, whereas H22 is 1 upon Z22. So you could see here we have written those equations of Z21 and we have written the equation of H21 and H22 by comparing equation number 5 with equation number 2. Now we have to achieve the remaining H parameters. So how we can do that? So those remaining H parameters can be obtained from equation number 3, which is still unused. So in equation number 3, what we observe is that we have parameters like V1, I1 and I2. We are going to compare this equation with equation number 1, wherein we have V1 as in equation number 3. We have I1 as in equation number 3, right? But we should have a V2. Instead, we have an I2 here. So what we will be doing is, we need to replace this I2 so that we get or we arrange equation 3 exactly matching with equation number 1. So how do I replace this I2 and by what? So for that, we have already derived the equation of I2 in equation number 5. So we have I2 in terms of I1 and V2. So that's what we will be doing. We will be replacing this I2 in equation number 3. Right? So we will be substituting this I2 with equation number 5, and we will get all the terms which are V1 in terms of V1 and I1, right? So we'll in the next step, now we are going to replace this I2 with equation number 5. And that's what you see here. What we have done is substituting equation 5 in equation 3. So equation number 5 was V1 Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. Now instead of I2, we are going to replace the I2 equation, which is this, into the equation of equation number 3, that is I2. We have replaced this I2 with equation number 5. So we'll multiply Z12 inside to each of the terms, right? Collect the like terms. So what are the like terms here? The like terms are I1, I1. So we'll collect all the terms of I1 together. So we get this equation. So if you see, this equation is very closer to equation number 1, which has parameters V1, I1 and V2. So we can directly compare this equation with equation number 1, and we can obtain the remaining H parameters. So the term associated with I1 becomes H11, and the term associated with V2 becomes H12. So comparing this equation with equation number 1, we obtain H11 to be this. Right, and we yesterday, as we discussed, Z11, Z22 minus Z12, Z21 can be called as delta Z. This particular product sequence can be called as delta Z. So we'll call this as delta Z divided by Z22 as H11, and the term with V2 becomes H12, which is Z12 by Z22. So this way we have related hybrid parameters with Z parameters. Similarly, proceeding ahead, we can now find hybrid parameters in terms of Y parameters, right? So this is your hybrid parameter equations, equation number 1 and 2, and equation number 3 and 4 are your Y parameters. Now we need to find out from the Y parameter equation which equation has terms similar to equations 1 and 2, right? So this way we can rearrange that equation. So we have to thoroughly look into equation number 3 and equation number 4 and see that in equation number 3 or in equation number 4, are there some terms which are very closer or similar to the terms which are in equation 1 and 2. So observing this, you know, in equations 3 and 4, we find that in equation number 3, we have terms I1, V1, V2. Right, so we have the terms I1, V1, V2, which are similar to the terms present in equation number 1. So in equation number 1 also we have V1, I1, V2. So these terms are very similar to the terms in equation number 3, and therefore we will rearrange equation 3 so that we write the equation in terms of V1. We will rewrite this equation number 3 and write it in the form so that we get V1 is equal to. So that's what is done here. We have rearranged equation 3 and we have written it in terms of V1 is equal to. So Y11 V1 is equal to I1 minus Y12 V2. Now to get V1 equation, we will send Y11 on the right hand side. So it becomes I1 by Y11 minus Y12 by Y11 into V2. So we can directly compare this equation number 5 with equation number 1. We can compare this equation with equation number 1. So what was equation number 1? Equation number 1 was V1, I1, V2. So V1 related to I1, V2, where the term associated with I1 becomes H11. And the term associated with V2 becomes H12. So whatever equation we have got now is very similar to equation number 1. And comparing, we say that H11 is 1 upon Y11 and H12 is minus Y12 by Y11. So we have got the two H parameters using equation 3. So equation number 4 is still unused. So if we compare equation number 4 with equation number 2, what do we identify? We say that we observe that there is I2 present in both the equations, right? And there is V2 also present in both the equations. The only term should V1 should be replaced so that we get I1 here, correct? So we need to replace V1 in equation number 4. So we are going to replace V1 with what we just derived from equation number 3. So we already have V1 in terms of I1, V2, which we called as equation number 5. So we will replace V1 from equation number 5 in equation number 4. So we are going to replace this V1 in equation number 4 by equation number 5. So with this substitution and rearranging the terms, okay, all the mathematics is shown here. So we have substituted V1 in equation number 4. Now we'll multiply Y21 to each of the term inside. We get this, and then we'll collect the like terms. So like terms are V2, V2 are the like terms here. So we'll collect all the terms associated with V2. Okay, and then now we can directly compare this I2 equation with equation number 2. So comparing this with equation number 2, we observe that the term associated with I1 becomes H21 and the term associated with V2 becomes H22. So we have H21 as Y21 by Y11 and H22, this is nothing but delta Y. So delta Y divided by Y11, where delta Y is this product sequence. So we have obtained hybrid in terms of Y, and the last conversion that we need to discuss is hybrid in terms of A, B, C, D parameter. So as usual, we'll first begin with writing the H parameter equation, calling it as equation 1 and 2. We'll go for writing A, B, C, D equation. So this is the A, B, C, D equation in terms of port voltage and port currents, which we'll call it as equations 3 and 4. So again, the procedure is identify one of the equation from equation 3 and 4 which can be similar to equations 1 and 2. And what we observe is that equation number 4 has similar voltage and current components as one of the equations from equations 1 and 2. So in equation 4, we have I1, V2, I2. Right? In equation number 4, we have I1, V2 and I2. Right? So this equation is very, very similar to equation 2, wherein we have similar components. Right? So what we do is, we will rearrange equation 4 and we will get it in terms of I2, I1, V2 and compare it with equation number 2. Right? We will calculate H21, H22. So I am going a bit fast because now you know the procedure. So we will substitute this equation number 5 in equation number 3 and get the remaining two parameters as shown here. So complete procedure for substitution and collecting the like terms is entirely shown here. So we get the equation of V1 in terms of I1, V2. So comparing it with equation 1, we get H11 as B by D, H12 is this. So I've gone a bit fast with the last thing because now you know the procedure. Okay, so need not tell the same things again and again. So friends, with this we have completed all the convergence. Right, we are